Evaluate the integral of 2 to the x dx. So the thing to keep in mind here is when you're integrating e to the x dx, the base e exponential, that is its own antiderivative. If we are integrating some other base, the process is pretty much the same. It's effectively its own derivative, but there's one more missing piece that we don't really write in when it comes to the base e. And the base e, effectively the rule is that you multiply by 1 over the natural log of the base. So what that means in terms of base e, because the natural log of e is just 1, is essentially the antiderivative of e to the x is its own antiderivative. So it's just e to the x is what I'm saying. But in terms of any other base, it is 1 over the natural log of whatever that base happens to be. And since that's not equal to 1, we can't just allow that to disappear. So you just need to know that rule. And whenever you come across a different base, you just simply consider it that it is its own antiderivative times 1 over the natural log of whatever its base is.